Hey everyone, it's Dale here from Crazy Good PowerPoint. Do you want to know how to create a really cool animated map in PowerPoint for any country you need? Then let's get going. Okay, first we're going to start with the Map SVG website. Then we'll go to Maps, and here we can download free SVG vector maps for the world, the US, or any country you'd like. Now I'm in New Zealand, so I'm going to choose New Zealand. And before I do, make sure you review the license details and give appropriate credit when you use this site. We'll download the map and then drag the file directly onto the slide. Then right-click, convert to shape. Right-click again and ungroup. Just to clean things up, I'll remove these islands so we're only focusing on the mainland. So I'll select this island and press delete. And there's another one here, so I'll get rid of that by drawing a shape over it. Then select that one, hold down shift, and then select the new shape. Go to merge shapes and subtract. And I'll do that again for these islands. Then we're going to select all by pressing down Ctrl A, and then we'll group them by pressing Ctrl G. Perfect. Let's just make this a little bigger, and we'll align it to the center of the slide. Fantastic. Change the shape fill to dark gray, and to hide the borders of each region, we'll also add a dark gray outline. Next, we'll come here, we'll right click, and duplicate the slide. We're going to choose this region here. Because it's grouped, we'll need to click again to select it. Then right click and change the fill to pink. And change the outline to pink as well. Now we want to zoom into this region. So hold down Ctrl and Shift and then resize it. We want to bring this region up to the middle. So we'll go up to View and select Guides. And make sure that this is placed right in the center. Now to see what this looks like, go to Transitions and select Morph. Beautiful. I'll speed this up a bit, so reduce the duration down to 1.25 seconds. Now let's check that out again. Perfect. Next we're going to add the region name, so we'll insert a text box. And we'll enter the region name, which is Canterbury. And we're going to use this map just to show population as an example. I'll reduce the size of this font down to 12, and I want to condense the letters a bit more, so select the text box. Then come up here, but I don't want to use the default tight setting in this case, as it's a bit too much, so we'll go to More Spacing. And we're going to choose Condensed, and we'll reduce this by 0.9, and click OK. Perfect, looks a lot nicer now. Now we're going to draw a little rectangle. And we'll get rid of the outline. Great. Select them both and hold down Ctrl plus G to group them. And this slide's done. Let's now right click and duplicate this slide. And we're now going to make this move to a different region in New Zealand. So to do that, we need to de-emphasize the Canterbury region. So we'll change the color back and we'll get rid of the outline by just making it dark again. And then we're going to drag the country down to this region here, which is Hawke's Bay, which just so happens to be a stunning place to live too. So select that region, right click, go to fill, and then go to outline. That looks perfect. We'll bring the text box a little bit closer, then edit this text to say Hawke's Bay, and we'll change the population too. To see what that morph looks like, go to Transitions, and we can preview it. Nice. But we can also change the morph setting to animate the text as well. So in Effect Options, we can change this to Characters. Now that hasn't worked because the text box is grouped, but that's okay. So what we'll do is ungroup them by pressing Ctrl Shift G. And I'll do the same here as both slides need to be the same for the morph to work. We'll come back here and we'll preview it again. Look at that, beautiful. To animate this back to the main map, we'll go to the first slide, right click and then duplicate, and then move it down. We just need to make sure we have the morph transition turned on, and we'll set the duration to match as well. And we're done. Now that's fantastic. If you like this video and want to see more, I'd love your support. So please press that subscribe button so you don't miss out. I'd also love to hear what you think. So please let me know in the comments below. And as always, I've provided the free download link in the description below. In my next video, I'll show you how to make this map clickable and interactive. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video.